which is equal to 1. Now, here is where you need to look at this and go, how do I want to attack solving this problem? And there's all kinds of ways you have of solving a three-variable system. I'm going to put links to other lessons, and it just depends on the math that you're in. You could do Gaussian elimination, like maybe you're taking this course inside of a linear you're looking at this topic inside of a linear algebra course, where you're studying Gaussian elimination and working through these systems through, you know, row reduction type thing. You could look at setting up a bunch of determinants and using Cramer's rule. I have a link to that lesson as well. Or you can be working with matrices. Now, if we let matrix A, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to talk through this process and just, you know, conclude the video and say we're done. But I'm also going to set up the camera on to probably my TI-84 and show you how to work out these calculator commands, because this is going to be a question when my kids take their test. It's going to be, this is a calculator question. So they're going to be allowed to use one of two operations in their calculator to get this answer. And one is with matrices. So we can set up matrix A as being the coefficients of 2, negative 1, 2, and 0, 1, negative 1, 1, 2, and negative 1. And then matrix B is going to be 4, negative 1, 1. Now, what we have here is that I can write this left side of this 3x3 system as this matrix times a basically another 3x1 matrix of x, y, or I was going to say x, y, and z, but alpha, beta, and k. And that would look like this, making sure I don't run out of room here, matrix A times a 3x1 matrix of first variable was alpha, then beta, then k, and that is equal to our constant matrix of, well, I can write 4, negative 1, 1, but I'm already using a variable here, so I'm going to say that this is equal to matrix B. Now what you want to do is, you want to get rid of this, you want to move this matrix A away from these three unknowns by multiplying both sides by an inverse, right? Like if you have x squared equals 16, you apply the inverse math operation to both sides, you square root. If you have the sine of theta equals 1/2, that's on the unit circle, so you should know what the answer is, but to solve that equation, you would get the theta angle measure out of sine by applying the inverse sine to both sides. Well, here you want to apply the inverse matrix to both sides, and we're going to have that this matrix of alpha, beta, and k is equal to the inverse of matrix A. Now, this is another way. We have Gaussian elimination. You could use Cramer's rule, and you could use like a matrix equation situation. Find the inverse of this 3x3 matrix. I have a math lesson on that too. I'll put a link in the description if you have to do this by hand. Find that inverse matrix and then multiply it to B, and then get your answers. It'll be a 3x1 matrix, which will be in sequence of alpha, beta, and k. And even quicker than that, maybe, what you could do is you can set up, since I'm already using sort of identifications of A, matrix A and B, you can find more room. Okay, I'm sure that was really loud on the microphone. And set up matrix C as, and you're going to set up a three-row, four-column matrix, 2, negative 1, 2, and 4. There's no way of putting like sort of an augmented matrix into your calculator, but you can just go straight across and have our coefficient of alpha, beta, k, and our constant. And then same with the second row, 0, 1, negative 1, and negative 1. 1, 2, negative 1, and 1. And then this, with this in your calculator, I'm writing lots of numbers and stuff here, so let's just one more time. Here we go. Good. Now, go into the matrix menu of your calculator and ask for a reduced row echelon form of this matrix. And what it's going to spit out is a matrix that looks like this. And I want to just look at this and make sure that I know the correct three answers. We're going to have 1, 0, 0, 0. Our second row is going to be 0, 1, 0, and 2. And then 0, 0, 1, and then 3. And basically, what I mentioned about initially, you can solve this 3x3 system by the Gaussian elimination in that reduced row echelon format. The calculator is doing that for you. You would have to make your very well, depending on your course, your teacher could be forced, you know, could be asking you, I had to do it too in class, to, you know, maybe, I don't know, like here we have a negative one and positive one, so maybe your first step would be to do row one plus row two to create, I don't know, maybe you wouldn't want a zero coefficient here, maybe you could do row one plus two times row two to create a zero here for a coefficient of k, but somehow work through the process of getting where you have a 3x3 matrix that has all zeros but a diagonal row of 1, and then the constants on the other side of your augmented matrix would be your answers, and we have that, well, alpha is equal to 0, beta, because that's the next variable in our column there, is equal to 2, and k is equal to 3. Now we can go back up here and say that looking at the equation of our line, now that we know that k is equal to 3, we can look at the equation of our line and say x is equal to 2 times 3, which is 6, y is equal to 3 minus k, 3 minus 3, which is 0, and z is equal to 1 minus k, which is negative 2, and get your coordinate, your point of intersection is 6, 0, negative 2. And you can also, I don't know why you'd want to, because we're done, but maybe if you want to double check your work here, and I'm just double checking mine as well, you can take alpha and beta, alpha of 0 and beta of 2, plug those variables into our parametric form for the coordinate of a point on the plane, and when you plug in alpha was 0 and beta was equal to 2, of course, if you've done everything right, you're going to get the same coordinates of your point. So, hold on, so you can see how you put this into your calculator quickly and where those commands are in your calculator. But otherwise, I'm done. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework. I don't normally record like this. So I hope this is comes out clear enough. But we're going to go matrix A. We're going to edit it. And we're going to put in that 3x3 matrix, which was 2. Negative 1, 2, 0, 1, negative 1. These are the coefficients that were on alpha, beta, and k. Last row, 1, 2, negative 1. I'm going to second quit to get out of this. And then we're going to put in second matrix B, which is 3 rows and 1 column. That's not what I meant to do. want to edit matrix B and put in that 3x1 matrix, which was 4, negative 1, and 1. Second quit. Now remember, we had matrix A times our 3x1 matrix of alpha beta k was equal to the 3x1 matrix of 4, negative 1, 4. If I multiply the inverse matrix to both sides, and this is how I'm going to do that, I want to do the inverse of matrix A times matrix B. So I'm going to go second matrix, choose A, and then I'm going to put on an exponent of negative 1, asking the calculator for the inverse of that matrix, and multiply that by matrix B. And there's my answers for, let's see, alpha, beta, k, which was 0, 2, and 3, like you saw in the video. Or I can go second matrix, let's do matrix C, and edit that. We're going to set up a 3-row, 4-column matrix. Now this time I'm going to include the constants at the end. So we have 2, negative 1, 2, and 4, 0, 1, negative 1, and negative 1, and 1, 2, negative 1, and 1. Now, another alternative way, again, of finding alpha, beta, k is to quit this, go into the matrix menu, do math, and you want a reduced row echelon form with matrix C. And there you go. That's how you use your calculator. To couple of ways, there's many more. Again, you could use determinants and Cramer's rule or just do this by hand, but that is how you find and solve quickly a three unknown, three equation system with your graphing calculator. One more time, I'm Mr. True, bam, go do your homework.